Your pre-approval is good for as long as the documentation that you've given me is not expired. And every single document has a timeline that it is good for. So your pay stubs need to be within 30 days of application date. They will expire at 60 days. So, you know, if you gave me a pay stub, we started the loan in August, and you gave me a pay stub that came from July, by September it's expired. So really, and that's why I say 30 days is probably the better number to keep in your mind. I need the most recent 30 days of pay stubs in the file at closing. So if a transaction takes 90 days, you submitted everything that they asked you for, you get into underwriting and you're sitting there and you're waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting, and then all of a sudden your loan is reviewed, then that underwriter's gonna say, well, we need updated pay stubs. Your credit report is good for 140 days. It is good for 4 months. If you are not, you know, if you are going to, that credit report is going to expire before the loan can be funded, then they're going to have to pull a new credit report. Well, what comes with a new credit report? What was that inquiry that you did in the last 4 months? Did you obtain new debt? All of those things that come up, just because of the waiting, it just, things expire and things need to be updated, just like bank statements.
Right. Anytime you give a new document, it can pose new questions. New questions pose new documents. So again, the longer a transaction takes, the more potential documentation you're going to have to continue to provide.
Right. So Heidi, I'm going to ask you and let you answer this question. Obviously, I know it, but I want people to know how smart you are.
Oh, that's nice.
So how good are the bank statements? How long are they good for? What is their expiration date?
So bank statements are good for 90 days.
That is right.
Okay. However, when you provide bank statements, they are good for 90 days. It does not mean that we're not going to need updated transaction histories depending on the type of transaction you're doing. And that would mean, do we need cash to close? Right? Are you going to bring in funds at the end of the transaction? So just because we have current
bank statements.
Thank you. I forgot my words. just because we said we have the current transactions doesn't mean we're not going to need a transaction summary showing that those funds have gone out now to escrow and that you still have a balance.
Right. So really more geared towards purchases more than refinances. Most refinances, you're not bringing cash in to close the transaction, so it's not as big of a deal. Now, there are clients that do not want to increase their loan amount and want to pay for their closing costs out of pocket, and in that situation, it'd be very similar to a purchase. When you are buying a home, you provide us with bank statements at the beginning that show us that you have enough money for your down payment and your closing costs, but things happen throughout the transaction. You get into escrow and you have to wire your earnest money deposit or your escrow deposit. And now we need to see that transaction history from the date of the last statement that was available, because remember, banks only give you a statement every 30 days. So we need you to go in and actually print that transaction history to show us that deposit that you sent cleared your account. There's other things that will happen throughout that transaction as well that we're going to also have to document. So if you're pulling money from your 401k and we need to see that it's come into your account, did you get a gift from your, you know, parents or family member that they sent you the money instead of directly to the escrow company? We're going to have to verify that you received those funds. So there will be updated statements that will take place on every single purchase transaction.
Yes, absolutely. And we will even ask you up till the day you close occasionally for an updated transaction history showing that those final payment out to escrow, final deposit, has gone and cleared your account. So it's something to be prepared for versus being frustrated at the close.
Right, absolutely. So that was a lot off topic. We were supposed to be talking
a little bit off topic.
It was, but it came up, and you know, I everybody says, you know, how do you know what you're going to talk about that day? And I go, things just spark my, you know, I think of something, and then it just comes out
what
of my mouth.
What she means is she doesn't know.
I have no idea. And, it's fresh every week.
Yeah.
I mean, I have an idea what we want to talk about, but sometimes we don't even get there. So let's get there. I do want to talk about this trust thing. You're the one that brought it up. We've had quite a few calls about it. One in particular that just came in yesterday. It was actually one of those clients that did talk with me. She's, I believe, 60 days into the transaction at her current bank right now. Very, very frustrated with them. Property is held in a trust. It is a rental property. And, you know, the bank is asking her for a copy of her trust, asking her for a copy of the lease agreements. She's very, very frustrated. She feels like that's personal information that she should not have to provide. So, and that comes up quite frequently. So it's something that I do want to talk about. I think, again, the more that people understand why and what is needed, makes it a little bit easier for them to prepare and to not be frustrated.
Right. The whys are so important. And I think so often lenders forget the whys. And clients, if they don't know why, then it doesn't make sense and they do get frustrated. So that's why I think this show is so important, is explaining the whys and knowing up front.
Right. So I haven't given the number for a while, haven't given the text number out. If you guys have questions, because we have talked about quite a bit already this morning, give us a call. It's 844-935-3634. Happy to help you with any question whatsoever that you may have about the real estate or mortgage process in general. So if there is any question, it comes down to, you have a problem with your appraisal, your physical inspection, your contractor, if you're having problems with your loan, if you just have basic questions, you're concerned about your credit, you want to get your trust set up, you need to do a checkup on your homeowner's insurance, we are here to help you through all steps and all pieces of the process. So please call us. It's 844-935-3634. That's 844 We Lend For You. That is LEND and the number 4. So 844 We Lend For You. You can also send us a message. Text the word MOM to 474747. You will get a response from me that says, hi, how can I help you? And then you can go ahead and ask me your question from there. So again, remember that the telephone number that you are sending the text message to is 474747. And in the body of the text message, you will type MOM. That will get you to us, and I will be able to see your messages and respond to you. Remember, I actually had quite a few people last week that sent me emojis and I think an attachment. It is a computer-generated program. Obviously, I'm doing the show, and I need to be able to see it from my iPad as we're sitting here and we're also talking at the same time. It is not an actual text message that I see as though it was on my cell phone, so I can't see your emojis. I can't see your attachment. So if you want to say LOL, don't send me the little guy with the tears coming out the side of his eyes. Send me an LOL. But we would love to hear from you. Please get those questions coming in, and happy to answer them for you right now. So let's talk about that. So client is upset that the bank is asking her for a copy of her trust. So let's start there. All right. I'm going to let you weigh in.
Okay.
Because you're just as smart as I am.
Sometimes. So when you are vested, your property is vested in your trust. So meaning that you took title in your trust. If you want to read.